Okay, Assalamualaikum. Today, our class, we will discuss chapter 2, DC and AC meters. Alright, so in chapter 2, we have discussed about the construction of the Arsène-Weil meter movement. We have done this. So now we are discussing this part. 2.2. Okay. So this slide consists of this part, DC ammeter. Okay, next. The learning outcome of this subtopic. At the end of this subtopic, the student should be able to explain the purpose of shunt cross ammeter. Okay, explain the purpose of shunt. What is the shunt? Analyze the DC ammeter circuit and insertion effect of DC ammeter. Okay, so we will discuss about ammeter. DC ammeter. DC ammeter is a device used to measure current. So it is a device to measure current, measure the amount of current flowing through circuit. So this ammeter is placed in series with the circuit. Okay, during the measurement, the ammeter is in series, is connected in series or parallel with the circuit. Which one? So ammeter is placed in series. Okay, voltmeter is measured, is connected parallel with the circuit. So it is very common equipment for electronics. The unit of ammeter is ampere or milliampere. Okay, ampere or milliampere, MA. So how we do or fabricate an ammeter from the Arsène-Weil meter movement that we have discussed in previous subtopic. So DC ammeter is fabricated by using the principle of the Arsène-Weil meter movement, but with slight modification. Okay, just small modification to the Arsène-Weil meter movement, then we can have DC ammeter, basic DC ammeter. So this is what we're going to discuss in this topic. Okay. So DC ammeter, how we modify the Arsène-Weil meter movement? So by placing a low resistance in parallel with the meter movement resistance. Okay, so as ni, you can see from here, placing low resistance. Okay, one is low resistance parallel with meter movement resistance. Okay, so there are two resistors. One is a meter movement resistance. This is called RM. And another resistance, which is parallel, another low resistance, which is parallel with meter movement resistance. This is called shunt, RSH. Okay, RSH. Why? Because by placing a low resistance in parallel with the meter movement, it is going to increase the range of current that can be measured by the meter. Increase the range of current. Range, the keyword is range. Range of current to be measured by meter. So this is ammeter. So RSH is known as shunt resistance. RM is known as meter movement resistance. Okay. So there are two resistors. One is RM and another one is RSH. SH means shunt. Shunt. See SH. So this is a example for the meter, the ensemble meter movement. This is the meter where you have the pipe. This is example here. You have the circuit, the current flow here. So the shunt resistor is in order for the current to flow through the meter. So small amount of this current need to flow through the meter so that you can measure the current. Okay, so the example here, there is a main pipe for the water flowing here, and the resistance here is high, the restriction here. So some of the water will flow through the bypass pedal wheel. Okay, so flow, there is a connection between the flow here and flow the bypass and flow the main pipe. If you can measure here, you can get the value here. Same goes to this ammeter. So there is two resistance here, shunt and meter movement. Okay. From this figure, we can see that the ensemble meter movement, RM, is in parallel. This is parallel. This is parallel. Parallel with shunt resistor, RSH. To limit, why is this being doing like this? Because it's to limit the amount of current in the movement's coil by shunting some of it through RSH. So if you have, this is the figure shown the meter movement and shunt resistance in parallel. Okay, now this is the current flowing through the meter, through the ammeter. So this current is big. So you don't want that this large amount of current flowing through a small resistance, because RM is very small. So if all this current flowing through this meter movement, then it might damage the meter. So what happened is you need to put one parallel resistor with the meter movement so that we can limit the amount of current that flowing through the meter movement, and the current will flow through the shunt resistor. Okay, so the purpose of doing like this, putting the shunt resistors parallel with the meter movement, is to limit the amount of current, to limit the amount of current in movement's coil, to limit the amount of current flowing here, okay, by shunting some of it through RSH, by let it flow through another resistance which is parallel to this one, RSH, shunt resistance. Okay, so in this figure, RSH is shunt resistance of the shunt. RSH also known as resistance of the the name is a shunt resistor, which means the resistor in parallel with the meter movement or the ensemble meter movement. RM is the internal resistance of the meter movement. Okay, ISH is the shunt current. This is the current through the The shunt resistor is known as shunt current. Im is the this one. Full scale reflection current of meter movement. So Im is the meter movement current. I is the full scale reflection current for the ammeter. I. Okay. Okay, remember this. So you need to remember this figure, the name of the of each of this current and resistance. Okay. Okay, from this figure, the same figure just now. Okay. Rm is the internal resistance. Also, this is Rm. So from this figure, you can see that we have this ammeter terminal here. Terminal here, let's say this is A. So this is B, sorry, this is B. This is A. So what are the ammeter terminal? Okay, let's see ammeter. Let's see ammeter terminal. I need to show you ammeter terminal. Yeah, sorry, using this one. This one. So this is what is okay. You can see here you have this yeah, you can see this is the parallel of the this is RM. Okay, RM is the coil here, the coil of this ladder, this what is this pointer. Okay, some coil here, small coil. So this is RM. RM represent this, the coil, this wire go here. So here you have some coil and pointer. So this is RM. Okay, shunt is RSH here, RSH. Okay, this is RSH. So I want to show the terminal. Okay, so this is the terminal here. Or mana terminal? This. So the terminal is this black and red. Red and black terminal. Positive and negative, basically, we call it. Okay? This one. So you have this, when you're measuring something, you have this terminal connected to the circuit. One is red and one is black. Okay? Okay, so this is black. For example, this is red. So this is the wire and goes to the meter lah. So this is basically this is the meter, internal part of the meter, and this is the wire. Okay, the current, when you're measuring the current goes through this wire. Okay, this is red wire, and you have another one. Black wire. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So from this figure, you can see that you have you have node here, node A and node B. So basically, anything sharing the same node is equal in voltage. Okay, so we can see from this figure that VRM is equal to IMRM. So V here V across RM, this is RM, is equal to IM multiplied by RM. This is Ohm's law. So V here, from here to here, is IMRM. So, but the voltage across RSH is equivalent to the voltage across RM. So we can say that VSH equivalent to VM. So VSH here is equal to VRM. Okay. Okay, here. Dana. ISH. So I flow from here. This is the current, the main current. So it goes from A, goes here. And one is going this direction, half of it or part of it going through this direction, and another part is going straight. Okay, one become IM, one part become IM and another part become ISH, depending on the value of the resistance. So we can say that I equal to IM plus ISH. So ISH equal to I minus IM. Okay, so I, the original equation, equal to ISH. Sorry, I'm writing using mouse. ISH plus IM. Ini kita panggil apa? Current division. The total amount of current. So this is Nodal law. Means the amount of current going out is equal to the amount of current going in into one node. So this, the main current here coming in this node, and this IM and ISH is current going out from this node. So amount of current going in equal to amount of current going out. Okay, yeah? So from this equation you get ISH equal to IM minus I minus IM. Okay, I minus IM. So I, what is I? Full scale diffraction current for the emitter I. Okay, yeah? Remember. So this is okay. Stand, eh? So by using this equation, so RSH ni apa? RSH is VSH minus I over ISH. So this VSH, the voltage here, voltage across VSH. So VSH is, V is I multiplied by R, VIR, okay? So R is V over I. So by replacing this VSH, because it is equal to this one, so IMRM over ISH equal to IMRM over 1 minus IM. So ISH, this one, like this in here, you get this equation. Okay. By saying that ratio of current diffraction to full diffraction multiplying factor N equal to I over IM, therefore RSH equal to RM over N minus 1. So you need to convert this equation using this. Okay. You make a new n, so n which is multiplying factor, n is the multiplying factor, n equal to I over Rm. So you put this n equal to I over Rm, new equation. So put this equation into this equation, and then you get this equation. The last equation, RSH equal to Rm over n minus 1. Okay. So example. Okay, so we will discuss about example in another session. Okay, however, you can try first. You can try first doing this so that you can, if you do and then you get the answer, you will increase your understanding. Okay, if I give you straight away the answer, then you might easily forget. You can use this equation. Okay. All this example is using this equation. Okay, calculate the value of shunt resistance. So this is RSH. Shunt resistance is RSH. So to convert a 1 millimeter movement, okay, this is what? 1 milliamp is I with a 100 ohm internal resistance. So this is Rm into a 0 to 10 milliamp ammeter. So this is 1 milliammeter movement is Im. Okay, so this is 0 to 10 is 10, this is the I, the big I. So this is I, this is Im, this is Rm, sorry, this is Rm, and this is RSH. So you need to calculate the value of RSH. So the answer is given already. You can try first. K here is the same. So 100 microamp meter movement. So this is current. Meter movement current is Im. Okay. Internal resistance, this is Rm. So Rm. Okay. This is 0 to 100 milliamp. This is I. Find the value of required shunt resistance. This is RSH. So you need to calculate the RSH. Okay. Okay. Next is you can have a multiple range of DC ammeter. So what we need to do to the circuit, to the basic circuit, in order to multiply the range. Okay. So multiple range. So you need to do modification of the shunt. Okay, for multiple range DC ammeter, it is also known as the universal shunt. Okay, so this universal shunt can be used on a multiple range ammeter. Okay, multiple range ammeter, meaning that it have more than one range. Okay, so it is used on a multiple range ammeter. It eliminates the possibility of the meter movement being in the circuit without any shunt resistance. It may be used with the wide range of meter movement. Okay, so in order to have multiple range DC ammeter, you need to have universal shunt. So there are two types of universal shunts. One is parallel shunt, another one is Ayrton shunt. Okay, two types. One is parallel, another one is Ayrton. Okay. This is the first one, which is called parallel. Okay, you can see that this resistance, which is shunt resistor, is in parallel with this meter movement Rm. How it become parallel? Okay, so R1 represent range 1. So if you want to change, if you want to use the range number 1 or range 1, can use RSH1 ataupun shunt resistor 1. Same wise, if you want to use range 2, you can use shunt resistor 2. If you want to use range 3, you can use shunt resistor 3. So this shunt resistor is used one at a time. Okay, so if you use shunt resistor 1, the rest 2, 3, 4 is not not in the circuit, not connected. Okay, you can see that this is like a contactor or the knob. So you can change the connection if you want to use this range. You place the connector here. Okay, so only this resistor is parallel, is connected and connected in parallel with the meter movement. So this is called parallel shunt. All this is shunt. Okay, what will happen if the switch lost contact during switching from one shunt to another when carrying current? So the problem with this parallel shunt is that it might happen that the switch lost contact during switching, because when you switch, this connector need to transfer from this one to this one, from 1 to 2. So during the transfer, it might lost connection. So the current already connected might flow all through RM and it can damage the meter movement. Okay, that is the problem. Okay, another one is another type is Ayrton shunt. Okay, so this Ayrton shunt is like this. So you have only one connection of the shunt. So RSH is here. Okay, all this resistor is connected. The resistor is connected in series. RA, RB, RC is connected in series. But all this connector is in parallel with meter movement, RM. Okay, so the connector for the range option is connected here through this point, and this point. Okay, so there is slight change in the theory. So you can see that by using this configuration, it can eliminate the possibility of the moving coil to be in the circuit without any shunt resistance. So whenever you choose the current, the range, okay, either 1, 5, or 10 amp, so the circuit, the RM is always being protected. Okay, always being protected. Okay, in this case, RSH is equivalent to RA plus RB plus RC. You can see from this figure, RSH, total RSH is RA plus RB plus RC. So what you can say here? So if you using 1 amp range, so the RSH become, the RSH become RA because this connector connect here and the current flow from here to here, right? This is not connected. So so you can see that this the shunt resistor is RA plus RB plus RC. Okay, but if you change this selector to this range, the current flow from here to here. So this is the node that the current will divide, okay? So half of it will go here. Sorry, a part of it will go here through this branch, and part of it will go here. So the shunt resistor now here, from here to here for this case. Okay, and Rm plus Ra become the movement resistance. So the current flow from here, okay, half of it will go this way and part of it will go this way. Okay, the same happen when we choose this range 10 amp. So here the current will flow here, and at this point part of it will go this way. Sorry, yeah, we use different color. Okay, part of it will go this way and part of it will go this way. So so the shunt for, we can say that when we select the 10 amp current, 10 amp range, so the shunt is RC and the meter movement will become Rm plus Ra plus RSH. Okay, so there is slight change in the calculation. Okay, so RSH is Rm over N minus 1. Okay, any other key? Okay, from this, at point B, just now, at point B, Rb plus Rc. Okay, when you measuring or opt for this selector for this range, just now you still remember here 1, 5, and 10, right? So the range, that is the range 1, 5, and 10. So when we select 5 ammeter range, so this is the calculation, this is the derivation. Point B, Rb plus Rc. This one, Rb plus Rc is in parallel with Ra plus Rm because the current flow this way and this way. Okay, so you can rearrange this circuit. Ra plus Rm, one parallel. Rb plus Rc, another parallel. Okay, so Vrb plus Rc. VRBRC here, the voltage across RB and RC equal to voltage across RA and RM, RA and RM. So rearrange this equation, RB plus RC multiplied by I2 minus IM, minus I2, this I2, the current flowing here, we call it IM, okay? The current here is I2 minus IM, so this is I2 go here, and here is IM. So IM here is I2 minus IM lah. Okay, so I2 minus IM go to IM, this current RA plus RM, RA plus RM. Okay, so solving this equation, so Ra is RSH equal to, sorry, Ra equal to RSH minus Rb plus Rc. So we know that the original RSH is from this to this. So RSH equal to Ra plus Rb Rc. So Ra equal to RS minus Rb plus Rc. Okay. So solving this equation, blah, 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 blah. This is quite long equation. Rb plus Rc equal to Im. RSH plus RM over I2. Okay. At point C here, so here, the current flowing I3 flowing here up this node. So This is I am. This is I3 minus I am here. Okay, solving the equation using the same principle. So at this point, RC is parallel with RB plus RA plus RM. So RB plus RA plus RM. Okay, this is two is not connected. So that's why. So I hope you can understand. So RC equal RC parallel with RA plus RB plus RM. So the current here, RB plus RA plus RM. Parallel with RC. So VRC equal to V here equal to V here. 1 RB VRB plus VRA plus VRM. Okay. So solving this equation again, you get RC equal to IM RSH plus RM over I3. So you can see the relationship between I3 and RC. So RC, we got I3 here, I3 RC just now. Okay, I2 RC RB, right? RB RC. Okay, substitute the equation. Okay, so you get this equation. RA equal to RSH minus RB plus RC. Okay, so RB is IM RSH. Susah ni equation. Okay, so basically you got the equation. This equation, 1 is RSH RM over N minus 1. Second equation is RB plus RC equal to IM RSH plus RM over I2. Third is RC equal to IM RSH RM over I3. And then RA equal to RSH minus RB plus RC. Okay, we will see the example. Okay. The example. Calculate the value for RA, RB and RC. RA, RB and RC. RA, RB and RC. Given the value of internal resistance RM, 1 kilo. Okay, here is given. Full state current of moving coil, 100 microamp. So this is RM. Full scale current moving coil. So this is RM. The required range is I1, 10 milli. I2, 100 milli. And I3 is 1 ampere. So I1 here, the most sensitive scale is always on the right, okay? I1. So I1 here, 10 milli, 100 milli and 1 amp. So all these value are given already. So you need to calculate the value of RA, RB and RC. Find the value of RA, RB and RC. So RA, RB and RC. Okay, this the solution is given, so you need to do the calculation. If you read, then you don't understand. You need to take out the calculator and do yourself and get the value. Okay. Okay. Example number 4. Okay, this is, you need to try this one. We will discuss later, another slide. Okay. So what happened when you measure, when you insert the meter into the circuit, there will be an insertion effect. They call it insertion effect. Some kind of loss, okay, the burden to the circuit. Okay, a frequently overlooked source of error in measurement. So if you insert the meter when you doing the measurement, basically you are putting some sort of circuit, small circuit, or the resistance, extra resistance to circuits. So basically, it is some it is a source of error for the measurement. All emitters contain some internal resistance. So as you know that there is some resistance for the emitter, all the emitter. So inserting an emitter in the circuit always increase. Okay. Inserting emitter in the circuit increase the resistance of the circuit. Okay. Therefore, reduce the measured current. Reduce the current. The error caused by the meter depends on the value of resistance of the emitter. Okay. Value of resistance of the meter. Also, the measured circuit. Okay. So, for example, this is the original circuit. So, when you want to measure at this point, you want to measure at this point. So you need to take emitter and then you need to take your probe and connect here in series. In series, connect here in series. So now you have emitter. This is the emitter which is represented by RM. So because this is your probe, okay, your probe, one is red and one is black. So this is your imaginary circuit. So you want to measure the current, the current flowing in this circuit. So without emitter you have the voltage source and the resistor. So the current flows. So when you want to measure, basically you put your emitter in series with the circuit. So now the circuit have two resistor. One is the original resistor R1 and another one is the emitter resistor, which is RM. Okay, so by putting your emitter, basically it is same that you're putting extra resistor. So from this, we call it, this is the insertion effect, and we need to calculate the error. Okay, we call it insertion error. Okay, so from this, if this circuit, the current flowing is just a V over R1. This is the original current flowing in the circuit, but the time you measure, there is a extra resistance RM, and the current become IM equal to V or E divided by R1 plus RM. So this is the measured current. Okay. So, what is the error, the difference between the measured and the exact current, or theoretical current? So, the error is IM over IE, okay? IM, this equation, over this equation. So, you can have this R1. Over R1 plus RM. Okay, you solve this equation. IM over IE, this one become R1 over R1 plus RM. Okay, this is the error. So insertion error is IE minus IM. Okay, IE minus IM. The error is the difference between a theoretical value and the measured. So IE minus IM over IE multiplied by 100%. So you can use this equation to get the insertion error in percentage. So percentage insertion error is IE minus IM over IE multiplied by 100%. Okay, example. So current meter, you can do this in your own time. Okay, summary. In this subtopic, we have discussed about shunt resistor in a single range emitter. Okay, we have discussed about single range emitter. So you only have one RSH. And the second is, we have discussed about multiple range emitter, and you have universal shunt, which is parallel and Ayrton shunt. And we have also discussed some calculation of shunt resistors and emitter insertion effect. Okay, conclusion, universal shunt. There are universal shunt, or also known as Ayrton shunt, used in a multiple range emitter. It eliminates the possibility of the meter to move, it eliminates the possibility of the meter movement being in the circuit without any shunt resistance. When you change the location of the selector, it might happen that there is no connected to any shunt resistance. So it may be used with a wide range of meter movement. So that's all. Hope you understand. Okay. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much. We will meet again in the next class. Thank you very much.